morning, I get into my car and start the engine. I hear the sound of a classic internal combustion engine which has ruled our planet for over 100 years. However, there are issues related to it. One, it is contributing to the greenhouse gases and global warming. Two, the crude oil is depleting. So what are the possible solutions? Hydrogen is believed to be a potential replacement. Although hydrogen is a clean and green fuel, we have limited resources available on our planet. So we have to think of other ways of producing hydrogen. Water is composed of hydrogen and oxygen atoms. And one of the efficient ways of producing hydrogen in large quantities is by electrocatalytic water splitting. The so-produced hydrogen gas can be stored and used as a fuel. So this is one half of the story. The other half of the story is that when we combine hydrogen and oxygen, we get back water. And this is called oxygen reduction reaction, which is opposite of water splitting. Oxygen reduction reaction is the primary reaction happening in a fuel cell, and the electrons related to this reaction is utilized to run a fuel cell. This concept resulted in a fuel cell car, which does not pollute our environment. However, both water splitting and oxygen reduction reactions are highly energy demanding and requires a catalyst to bring down the energy barrier. Presently, the fuel cell cars are very expensive because the catalysts used in these cars are made up of noble metals. My research is to discover a catalyst with minimum energy input and get maximum energy output. To do this, I have synthesized a catalyst called hybrid catalyst, which is composed of a cheap metal and a conductive carbon. For example, cobalt selenide on graphene is active for both water splitting and oxygen reduction reaction. Cobalt selenide acts as the catalytically active site, and graphene helps in quick electron transfer. The combination of cobalt selenide and graphene can be compared into a romantic couple sharing and caring for each other. But I don't know to what extent they fight. I don't have an answer for that. So this sharing and caring between cobalt selenide and graphene is called synergistic effect, which contributes greatly in reducing the energy barrier. Since the same catalyst is active for both water splitting and oxygen reduction reaction, the overall synthesis cost can also be reduced. As of now, I'm trying to improve the stability of these catalysts in harsh conditions. My research shows that when we use a hybrid catalyst, we can bring down the energy barrier, reduce the cost, and have an extended lifetime of catalyst. I hope in the near future, every morning I get into my fuel cell car and start the engine. I don't hear any noise or pollution. Thank you.